So now that we looked at our first two plotting libraries, Seaborn and ggplot, let's look real quick at how to customize them with matplotlib. And that's possible because both of these use matplotlib to actually render these plots. So they abstract away a lot of stuff, add behavior, change the design of these plots, but they use matplotlib to actually render these plots under the hood. Okay, so let's start with Seaborn. In Seaborn, most functions simply return a standard matplotlib axes object. So if we call seaborn.displot, this returns an axes object, and we can simply assign that to a variable. And if we now print the type of that variable, we see that this is a matplotlib.axes.axes subplot. And now we can simply use methods which we know from this axes subplot object, and for example, change the title here. So note that it always prints, it automatically displays the plot, even if it's not the last thing in our cell. But we can then work on the axis object and it's changed, so it displays it at the very last thing after we added, for example, our title here. Alternatively to having Seaborn return this axis object, we can simply pass it an axis object to plot on. So we can first create an axis object using our standard figure axis equals figure.subplots, and then we pass this to our Seaborn displot, and then we can continue working on our axis object. For example, we can set the title and the x label here, and now it works like this. All right, in ggplot it's a bit different because we have to call this draw method. So ggplot, again, it doesn't come from object oriented programming languages like Python, so it has a different syntax. So what we have to do is, from our standard ggplot call, which we saw earlier, we now have to call the .draw method. And this here then creates a matplotlib figure, which we can assign to a variable. Note that it returns a figure and not an axis object. So we can, so if we have multiple plots, for example, by faceting, this will return a figure where there are multiple axis objects on. Okay, and also ggplot draws it automatically, even if it's not the last statement in the cell. Okay, now we see that the type of this figure, which we assign to the fig variable here, is matplotlib.figure.figure. And if we want to change their axes, what we can do is, well, figure, give me the first axis object here, because it's only one plot, it's a figure with only one axis, and set the title, for example. And this then, so now, of course, if it's not the last thing, it doesn't automatically plot it, but we can display this figure. Because the .draw returns a figure object, we can of course also use method chaining. So create this and this plot, create the figure object, and then we have the figure object here, and from this figure object we can take, for example, the first axis object and set the title like this. And now, well, here it returns me that I set the title. If I have a semicolon here, it does only draws the plot. All right, and now I have one exercise here for you, because our first attempt at the violent plot with Seaborn looked fine, but the xtick labels said I didn't like them. Let's fix this by using matplotlib to change it. So we pass an xtick, we create an epsis object, we pass that to Seaborn, and then we rotate the xtick labels using this code. All right. So how do we do this? Well, first of all, we create an axis object using our standard plt.subplots call. And then let me copy that, because I did that already above. So we have our violin plot and we pass it our axis object. And then simply afterwards we use our axes.setXtickLabels code. Now, let's make a semicolon here such that it doesn't return this. And now it plots the plot nicely.